Fam, this is crazy. Michelle wanted to guaza Leroy. Leroy has come out here putting everything out in the open for the world to see. So let's get into Leroy's statement. His statement reads, I, Dumezweni Leroy Sidambe, would like to address recent allegations that have surfaced on 4th August 2024 regarding gender-based violence against my partner, Michelle Ndamase. I've always upheld the values of respect, equality in our relationship and interactions. It is disheartening to see how quickly misinformation and manipulation can spread and how easily someone's character can be called into question without a thorough understanding of the facts. Well, in our defense, they really gave us nothing or little to go on with, okay? They didn't give us the facts, so of course we'll run with what we have. Continues to read. As someone who has experienced the disturbing and hurtful impact of these issues personally, I empathize deeply with victims of gender-based violence. On the 4th of August, Michelle Ndamase attempted to contact me by placing a total of 78 calls, of which I wasn't able to attend, I think, as I had fallen asleep. Michelle then arrived at my residence and persistently requested that my son open for her so she could see me. Upon arriving, as my son recollects, she headed to the kitchen to equip herself with a knife in the attempt of stabbing me, as she allegedly was shown evidence of me being unfaithful. Michelle Ndamase then came to my bedroom as I was asleep to confront me about being unfaithful and attempted to stab me, in which I then protected myself by pushing her away from me, resulting in her sustaining her injuries as she made contact with the wall. My son then came to my rescue after hearing me shouting and pleading for Michelle not to take my life. With this being said, I would like to inform you all that Michelle has a long history of physically assaulting me and damaging my property, especially when she's under the influence of substances I cannot name. It is important to note that there's a plethora of witnesses, my children and bystanders, who can attest to me not ever laying a hand on her during or after any altercations, but always deflecting and defending myself accordingly. It is unfortunate that Michelle Ndamase would use her platform to spread these harmful allegations to ploy against my public image in the attempt of being revengeful. I assure you all that I will continue to cooperate fully with any inquiries, especially from authorities, to clear my name and restore my reputation from this. Thank you for your understanding and for your support during this challenging time. Signed, Dumezweni Leroy Sidambe. Then he went on to also share his call registry, which here shows that Michelle called those 78 times he's talking about, okay? And thereafter, Michelle came out with a post of her own that is a two-sided narcissist post, and it reads, there are two sides to every story. There's the narcissist version of events, which seems to have nothing to do with the original story. She seems to be the queen of subliminal posts, so I don't know, she did that with the first post of her revealing her scars and bruises, and now she's doing it with this, still not saying much, but this. So I guess we are allowed now to take it and run with it however way we want to. But now as it stands, Leroy's statement, there's something believable about it, even though it is making her look very crazy and unstable. Okay, but I still think they're both dysfunctional, abusive human beings to each other, and they deserve each other. And I love how they are tearing each other apart without Mary Jane having to lift a finger. Okay, and when it comes to the 78 missed calls that she left him, I'm just like, who does that? Huh? Who in their right mind calls anybody 78 times? What are you hoping for? That maybe the 110 times they will then pick up the call? I guess that's making you look very unstable and crazy. And also there's something Leroy mentioned in the statement, saying that Michelle has a history of physical assaulting and damaging his property, especially when she's under the influence of the substance he cannot mention. And I don't know how true that is, but there has been rumors that Bobby's friends do things of that nature. So Michelle's Bobby is one of Bobby's friends. Maybe she does that. I don't know, her being physical to him and damaging his property. On that, Mihlali has a history of being physical and aggressive with a man. So maybe her being abusive and physical with Leroy is not something that is far-fetched. Okay, just recently Mihlali was aggressive and laid hands on Musa Kaula, giving him this and this past the lip. So there is a possibility that she was aggressive and abusive with Leroy, especially if he cheated. You know why? Because baddies always think they are high up there with the angels, and that because they have beautiful faces and beautiful bodies, they are the envy of majority of men, they can be cheated on. Even though the same Leroy cheated on his wife with Mihlali, she somehow in her head was like, I am the Mihlali Ntamazi, so he won't do the same thing to me. Maybe. So she got the surprise of her life when he actually did exactly what they did to his wife. Because that was something that she wasn't even thinking about, I assume. So it came into life, him cheating on her drove her absolutely insane. Hence why she allegedly now went, equipped herself with the knife, and was trying to be a Magwaza and sent him to his early grave with that. And in this very moment, I just want the side chicks, to the intentional side chicks, because there are those who become side chicks unintentionally and walk away instantly after finding out. But there are those who are intentional about it. Come here. Yes, a bit closer. Yes, you too. Come here. Tell me, what makes you think it is okay to then go date somebody's husband, meaning you and the husband are cheating on the wife, hating the wife and their family, and then now try to take their lives? What makes you think that is okay? Or maybe in your delulu mind, you're just like, I know he's starting this cheating with me and it's gonna end here. Is that it? Whatever potion you all take to have the kind of liver you have, I don't want it. I pray against it. So yeah, you can go back to your seats. And as for wives, my heart bleeds for you. Like, the way y'all are disrespected by these babies once they date your husbands. Y'all remember when Mihlali was in the same salon as Mary Jane this, and she was acting as if she's not sleeping with her husband, and she was just like poised and comfortable, and even made this vlog and posted it. And even after the backlash, people calling her to take it down, she didn't, because she won the man and Angeriana. Gandhi, no, she didn't win the man. She won Mary Jane's problems. This almost 80 calls donor. They scream psychotic. They scream, I'm not okay. But yeah, really dangerously in love, Lena. You are his peace, right? You know what? All I'm going to say is that the day Mihlali agreed to be Leroy's girlfriend, side chick, whatever, lover, partner, they call it these days, that was the day her life started going downhill. How I wish they never met, these two. Because before then, I looked at Mihlali as this beautiful girl who can do no wrong. But now, I'm just like, girl, I wish you can see what the world sees when they look at you. I wish that is what you can see in the mirror when you look at yourself. Because then, if you can see yourself for how we see you, you will understand that you have no business being with married men. You will understand that there's a man, a single man, a man that is not married out there, that can treat you so well, love you so loudly, and you be his peace because you like being man's peace. Be his peace in peace. Not this. And Mihlali is really traumatizing me when you think about it, and the rest of the people who love her, because we are like, girl, as for wena dumezweni, kuri, you came into Mihlali's life and brought nothing but disturbance. English ran, so I'm gonna go with disturbance. Yeah, you brought nothing but disturbance. Now look at yourself. Look at yourself, wena dumezweni. You left your beautiful wife there and came to the streets Now the streets are not kind. And you're telling us about it. You're now embroiled in this mess. She now wanted to quasar you until you meet your maker. If what you're saying is true, she now damages your property. Fam, let's do take all of this to the comment section and like the video, share, subscribe if you're not. And until next time, bye and thank you for watching.